right, guys. So one of the most frequently asked questions we get here at the Hush Channel is, how does one go about hunting a new state? It can be a very daunting task. The best tool we believe there is out there is the Go Hunt Insider Program. So you go to Go Hunt and become an insider. Now, when you do sign up for the Insider Program, you need to use the code HUSH at checkout. What that's going to give you is automatically you're going to get $50 credit to the Go Hunt online store. They sell everything from trekking poles to tents to sleeping bags to optics, everything you're going to need. Also, what you're going to get when you become an insider is access to all the information you're going to need to hunt in a new state. Now, the Go Hunt Insider Program is great because it covers all the western states and all the species that live in those states. But because the Colorado deadline is fast approaching, we're going to talk about Colorado mule deer. One of the first things I would recommend doing is going to the Insider tab and going to these strategy articles. They write strategy articles for all the states and all the species, but we're going to look at the Colorado mule deer this year. So in this article, it has all the information to get you started on your research. It's going to talk about why you want to hunt Colorado, what's new for 2019, some state information, some important dates and information. It's just full of information. Information you're going to need to apply for Colorado. So one of the things we would recommend you guys doing when you decide what new state you want to hunt is go to that state's fish and game website and download their big game proclamations. Every state is a little bit different. Every state has its own set of rules and laws. As sportsmen, we are responsible to know those laws and abide by those laws when we hunt in a new state. That is very critical. So the way Colorado works is pretty much all the deer hunts are by application only. There are no over-the-counter deer tags for non-residents in Colorado. So what we can go look at next is, what are our chances of actually getting a tag? So you go to the Insider and then you go to the Draw Odds tab. Now the Go Hunt Draw Odds are probably the most up-to-date draw odds there are out there. And when you click on the Draw Odds, there's going to be a couple different filters you can use. So we're going to look at Colorado. We are non-residents because we're going to be hunting a new state. And let's look at mule deer. So once we get to the draw odds, there's a couple different filters you can use. We're going to go to Colorado, we're going to go mule deer, and we're non-residents. So we've never applied for Colorado before, so we have zero preference points. Now it is important to know that Colorado has a true preference point system. What that means is the guys with the most points are going to get the tags first. So if I'm applying and I have 6 points, and you're applying and you only have 1 point, I will get that tag before you do. But that is okay, because the great state of Colorado, there is a lot of opportunity. The next thing you're gonna need to decide is, what type of hunt are you looking to do? Are you looking to do an archery hunt? Are you looking to do maybe a muzzleloader hunt? Or maybe you're wanting to do a rifle hunt. Now, a lot of units in Colorado offer up to 4 different rifle seasons. Now, let's just go look at one of them. Let's say we want to apply for Colorado mule deer for 2019, and we want to do a, say, second season rifle hunt. So the early rifle, and then here's the second rifle. What are our chances of actually obtaining a tag in Colorado our first year applying with 0 points? So you look at the draw odds here, and you look at the breakdown. So you look at the very far right, and this is the 0 point preference pool. What are our chances of drawing a tag with 0 preference points? So as you scroll down, you can see, hey, 50% in that unit, it's not bad for 0 points. 83%, not bad. Well, look at this one. That's 100% draw odds with 0 points in that unit. Here's some more, 100%, 100%, 100%. There's quite a few, actually. Let's look at this one. So this tells me right here the draw odds. As you can see, for the last 4 years, it's been 100% draw odds with 0 points. You scroll down a little further and it talks about, this is the amount of applications there were last year and in 2017 and so on and so on. This is the amount of tags that were drawn in those years. We scroll down a little further, you can see that this unit, the trophy potential. It says that there's 170 inch plus trophy potential. That's not saying that you're gonna go out and kill 170 inch deer. That's just saying that's the potential. I would say there's a potential of killing 190-inch deer as well. It just gives you a little bit of insight of what you can expect. How about harvest success? This unit has a 37% harvest success. That's pretty good. Buck to doe ratio. There are 33 bucks to every 100 does, the biologist figures in that unit. Not bad. Okay, so we looked at the draw odds. We found a unit that we could draw our first year for the second rifle with 0 points. So here's another tool that's very important, I believe. So we go to the Insider and let's go to State Rules and Regs. We click on this. So this is gonna give us a map of all the states that GoHunt has information for. Well, we're looking at Colorado, so let's click Colorado. So this is important because it gives you a very in-depth look at some more important details about hunting Colorado. So here's our license cost. So as you can see, a general hunting license, which is required to apply, is $81.75. Habitat stamp is $10. One thing that's changed this year is it is now a $9 application fee, as in years past, I think it was $3 to $5. So it's gone up a little bit. And then once you draw, because we're 100% guaranteed to draw, it is going to set us back $396.75. So you're looking at hunting Colorado for mule deer for just under $500. You had some important dates here. So important dates, April 2nd, like I said before, is the last day to apply. I believe it's 8 p.m. on April 2nd. Some quick rules, just more in-depth information about Colorado and the draw system. But I think what's most important about this is this map right here. So we're going to dive in here, and we found the unit that we think we're going to hunt, that we're going to draw, and we click on it. Now this here gives you a very in-depth look at what you can expect once you draw your tag in this unit. So this talks about the mule deer, the size, the trophy potential. If you're looking to pick up an elk tag, what's great about Colorado is there's a lot of over-the-counter opportunities for elk. You can add an elk tag to your deer tag once you draw the deer tag. It talks about terrain, vegetation. What I think is probably one of the most important things is it shows you how much public land is in that unit. This unit has 75.4% public land. That's really good. Another very important thing is the access. Where can you obtain access to get into the backcountry to hunt deer? This tells you some places to go try. This talks about camping and lodging. If you're a hotel guy, where you can get a hotel, places to camp. Talks about the weather, which is pretty in-depth here. Talks about precipitation. If you're a guy that's playing antler growth and all that, that's good information to have. And then it goes through and talks about each of the seasons, the archery season, the muzzleloader. This is a second rifle. This is what we were talking about doing here. So this tells you a little bit of information about what to expect when you're in this unit on the second rifle. So it says bucks will be great difficult during the season as they will be living among timber and no longer in bachelor groups. Very in-depth information about what to expect once you get there, and so on and so forth. So that is a quick look at one state, one unit, one species. And like I said earlier, the Insider has in-depth information about almost every western state and every species that lives in that state. We talked about Colorado because the deadline is fast approaching. So in the future, Nevada, Oregon, and Idaho, once those deadlines get closer, we will do in-depth videos about how to apply for those states. But the most important thing you could do right now is go sign up to be a GoHunt Insider, and you will have access to all of this information. This information will help you hunt in a new state. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hopefully it was a help. But make sure when you sign up to be an Insider, use the Hush discount code at checkout to get the $50 to the store. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time on the Hush Channel. Ooh.